Now that we've recorded rent payments and we've made invoices to indicate that we've earned the rent, now we have to make sure we apply rent payments to the proper invoices. Before we do that, let's quickly review a little bit about the customer balance detail. Now, when we look at the tenant balance detail, we can see that on January 31, Holden owed Donna $5,000 in future rent services. But then on February 28th, that amount decreased. Actually, it's Dave. Holden owed Dave $5,000. If Dave moved out on January 31, Holden would have to pay him $5,000 and give him his money back. But Dave stayed another month until the end of February. So at the end of February, if Dave moved out, Holden would only have to pay him $4,000. Same situation with Donna, even though the numbers are slightly different. If Donna moved out at the end of January, Holden would have to pay her back $6,000. If Donna moved out at the end of February, Holden would only have to pay her $4,800. So the customer balance detail gives you a lot of information about your financial relationship with your tenants. In fact, this report is such a good report that it would be hard for you to believe that the open invoice report is even more important than the customer balance detail. The open invoice report should show only the net amount remaining. Only invoices that are not paid or only payments that are not yet used. It should not show both. When we take a look at it, we can see that there's the entire payment up here, even though invoices have been applied to this payment. And these two invoices are technically paid, even though they're showing up on the open invoice report. So after you enter your monthly invoices, you need to rectify this problem by applying the payments to the invoices. You must choose which payments to apply to which invoices. We will apply the payments in date order. Now, if you don't apply any of the invoices to any of the tenants' payments, the open invoice report will look almost the same as the customer balance detail, except the customer balance detail has the running balance. So this report is useless unless you apply them against each other to get the net amount. It's very simple to apply them against each other. Once you do that, whichever one has the lower number will disappear, and the one with the higher number will remain on the open report. So in the example with Dave, when we apply these two invoices to this payment, these two invoices will no longer be on the open invoice report because they will be marked as paid. And the payment amount on the open invoice report will decrease to $4,000 because that's the amount of the payment that remains unused. Same thing with Donna. These two invoices will be applied to this payment. That means that when we're done on this open report, these two invoices will disappear, and the only thing you will see for Donna is the remaining amount of the payment unused, which I think is approximately $4,800. Actually, you can predict it very accurately by looking at the net total on the bottom of each customer. So, it's very simple to apply a payment. Double-click the earliest invoice. Make sure the ribbon is showing. Make sure you choose the main tab and then click over here, Apply Credit. Now, the only payment or the only credit available is the big one that was made at the beginning of January. Since there's only one, QuickBooks automatically has put the check mark here to choose this one to be applied to invoice number one. Just click Done, and then all you have to do is click Save and Close. And now notice that invoice has disappeared and the unused payment amount has decreased to $5,000. Let's do it for Dave's other invoice. Double click, apply credit, It's already marked off because it's the only credit. Click Done. Click Save and Close. And now notice, Dave's section of the open invoice report has no invoices because both of his invoices have been paid, and his remaining unapplied payment that he has not yet used for his rent yet is $4,000. Let's do the same thing with Donna the tenant. Double-click her earliest invoice, click Apply Credit. The computer already chose her payment. Click Done and click Save and Close. And that invoice disappeared and her unapplied payment amount has decreased. Let's do it one more time. Apply Credit, click Done, Save and Close. And now all of Donna's invoices have been applied to the one big payment that was made first. And this is the remaining amount of payment that Dave has not yet used for his rent. And this is the remaining amount that Donna paid that she has not yet used for her future rent. If you ever need to see which payments were applied to which invoices, you can open the transaction history window at the top of every invoice. So, if you only look at the open invoice report, there are no invoices there. There are only unapplied payments. To see the invoices, you should click the tenant balance detail and notice that it remains unchanged regardless of which invoices were applied to which payments. Now, if you double-click any of these invoices, they're going to say paid. And you could always print this for your tenant to show the months that they did pay for. But if you want to see which specific payments were applied to this invoice, you would click Reports and then Transaction History, and you would see a list of payments that were applied to the invoice that you double-clicked and opened. In this example, there's only one payment that the tenant made on January 1. But if the tenant made several payments and several of those payments were applied to this invoice, the transaction history window would show it. You can also find which invoices were applied to which payments by opening up the payments and seeing what invoices are listed there. So again, if we go back to the customer balance detail and double click on the actual payment, you will see at the bottom of the payment window, the invoices that this payment is applied to will be listed here. If you ever have a situation where you have applied a payment to the wrong invoice, you can use the payments window to unapply or reapply a payment to a different invoice. Please see the supplemental videos that I have provided as part of this playlist for this course. One of them clearly shows the nuances and details of the receive payment window and shows how to reapply a payment that has accidentally been applied to the wrong invoice. That's a very unlikely situation. Payments are almost always applied to invoices in date order.